President Obama, who this morning is on his way back to Washington after receiving his Nobel Peace Prize yesterday, at a ceremony where much of the talk was about war, not peace. CBS News senior White House correspondent Bill Plant has more. Bill, good morning.
Good morning to you, Maggie. That's right. The president defended Afghanistan, America's role there. And in a 60 Minutes interview to be broadcast this Sunday, he says that defeating al-Qaeda is not possible without help from Pakistan. And he also says that it's probably not possible either to completely wipe out terrorism.
Will we have no terrorist threat once this is completed? Unfortunately, that threat will probably be with us for a longer period of time. But will we be safer than we otherwise would have been, and would the investment have been worth it? I think the potential is yes.
Accepting the Nobel Peace Prize in Oslo Thursday, the president, who had just ordered 30,000 more troops into Afghanistan, had a sobering message. War is sometimes necessary.
I understand why war is not popular, but I also know this. The belief that peace is desirable is rarely enough to achieve it.
Mr. Obama reminded his audience that American arms stabilized the post-World War II world.
From left to right, he's got nothing but plaudits, and that's rare for any president, and particularly a president in bad times.
Political analyst Larry Sabato says the president tried to reconcile his troop increase with the prize for peace.
It wasn't a speech of apologies for what America has done. It was more of an attempt to explain to Europeans why America has done what it has done and to defend the involvement in Afghanistan.
The president comes back here this afternoon to face his two biggest domestic priorities right now, health care reform and, of course, unemployment. But he goes back to Europe again next week to Copenhagen for the talks on climate change. Maggie?
A lot on his plate. CBS's Bill Plant. Thank you, Bill.